don't shed a tear for them to see. It's 8:49, October 15th.
find it fletching on the ground. That's kind of a tell right there that it could hit a tree limb. So we'll look around and see, maybe find something.
So I took that shot and I was this far off. I hit that tree and my arrow deflected and it just, about a 30 degree angle, bam, gone. It took me over an hour to find it and circle and look and buried. But I wasn't looking up there because I thought I hit it. Pretty much on my hands and knees, picking apart, looking and trying to find the most speck of blood because I was confident that I hit him. But I guess one thing I did learn was play the cards at hand and figuring out where the deer went. Okay, did you hit him? What's he doing? Where's he stopping? You know, because you could take those little things. Hey, look, he stopped by that little cedar. We need to look for blood there. And just taking more mental notes, whether it's your arrow flight, exactly where the deer was standing, and then where that deer walked off. Shot-wise, I mean, I was that far off. But just being more aware, I think, is one thing I should have done, and it would have saved a lot of time out there and a lot of walking around. I'm gonna give it a break for the next couple days, go to a public spot I got that I've been waiting for it to heat up. So it's actually conservation ground. I don't have any cameras in there, but we're gonna go in there and see if we can find something and let this cool off for a couple days.